Welcome to the NIBR Science of Therapeutics Symposium on SARS-CoV-2 antivirals. We are 18 months into one of humanity's most challenging chapters, the COVID-19 epidemic. To date, more than 170 million individuals have fallen ill with this virus, and there have been 3.7 million deaths. These numbers are horrifying and humbling. These 18 months have challenged all of us and each of us personally and professionally. And indeed, we're not yet out of danger as the virus spreads still, in particular in India, Brazil, and elsewhere. This time has come with incredible, also actionable learnings. We've seen the truly awesome power of biomedical research to organize and nimbly reposition mature vaccine platforms toward SARS-CoV-2 with breathtaking creativity, efficiency, bravery, and effectiveness. And indeed, today, more than 2 billion vaccine doses have been estimated as administered. And in regions where vaccines are accessible, cases, hospitalizations, and deaths are all declining. But still, we worry. We worry about those who cannot access vaccines or even basic medical care. We worry about resistant variants. We worry about new strains. As scientists, we must anticipate a next zoonotic transmission of the coronavirus family, and we must be better prepared. It's remarkable to consider that we've managed this pandemic so well without having access to intentional coronavirus therapeutics at the outset. Through this pandemic, amidst the innovation of vaccines, a community of like-minded scientists has assembled to innovate first intentional coronavirus medicines. We've all taken stock in our unique disciplinary strengths and therapeutic platforms. Some work to mechanistically repurpose nucleosides for coronaviruses' replication complex. Others imagine biotherapeutics to block the spike protein. At NIBR, we directed a first, COVID proteomics platform built to drug human cysteines and map druggability in the human proteome towards the catalytic cysteine of SARS-CoV-2 and other main proteases in this family to innovate a first pan-coronavirus medicine, all to be better prepared. Typically this work, especially in industry, is quietly and commonly competitively undertaken, but also through this pandemic, we've seen a new posture from competitors as collaborators, and this new behavior, this more open framework, makes us so hopeful. Amidst the disruption of this time, it's been very hard for scientists to gather in the way that we're used to in beautiful ski slope villages, comparing notes on unpublished work. We have enjoyed many virtual conferences from some long-standing symposia, but awkwardly through this time, there's been very little attention paid to the invention of first coronavirus medicines. There was a wonderful symposium from the National Institutes of Health that many of us had the pleasure of attending, and this inspired us to have a ruthlessly scientific, atomic level gathering of drug hunters, motivated and interested, some making dramatic progress towards first intentional coronavirus therapeutics. So enter NSofT. If you're here today, you're here for the launch of a new type of gathering of interdisciplinary scientists, clinicians, scientifically curious members of our global community, NSofT, the NIBR Science of Therapeutics Symposium. We hope this becomes an energizing event annually for drug hunters to gather and compare notes on new technologies and grand challenges. And it's fair to say that SARS-CoV-2 is indeed both. Before closing, I'd like to thank the NIBR scientists who've taken the initiative to design and curate NSofT, Ann Granger, Ian Hunt, Heather Hope, Vishal Patel, and honestly, so many others who are session chairs of this meeting today. We've been blown away, but not surprised, by the global curiosity of this meeting with its estimated 2,000 or 3,000 attendees. So welcome. I'm Jay Bradner, president of NIBR, but for this symposium, a chemical biologist interested in bringing the power of covalent chemoproteomics to bear on the main protease of the coronavirus. Like all of you, I look forward to listening and learning through this day.